Welcome back to the Jogwheel channel. My name is Jonathan Paula, and on today's episode of Tech Check, we're going to be taking a look at WOLFEE. No, it's not some weird furry cosplay thing. It's actually a brand new HCI device that allows you to manipulate and control devices in your household like never before. So a couple weeks ago, the folks at WOLFEE reached out to me and asked me if I wanted to demo and review their product a year before it's released commercially. And of course, I said yes to that opportunity. I don't want to say that I was outright impressed with everything, because inherently it is just another remote control, another form of a remote control. But there are a lot of promising features here, which is why I'm going to keep my eye on it. So the WOLFEE is a small, lightweight, handheld device ergonomically designed for right-handed people. It weighs only 4.7 ounces, has just three buttons. A back trigger, a side trigger, and a trackpad of sorts that you can also click or tap. The built-in lithium-ion battery is rechargeable by a standard USB micro cables and has a battery life of about 1 week under typical use. Now, I only got a chance to play with it for a single afternoon because it was the prototype and I had to give it back. But that said, I think my immediate impressions were, wow, this thing feels fantastic. It is very, very comfortable. But what also struck me is the lack of any labels, text, or marks anywhere on WOLFEE. It's just three buttons and a ring of blue light. That's it. It's very simple, very clean, and I think this would look good on anybody's coffee table. But perhaps most importantly, how does WOLFEE work? Well, it's simple. You connect it to any of its compatible devices via Bluetooth, whether that's a Windows 10 PC, an Android phone, a smart TV, or whatever. You don't have to really teach it anything. You don't have to download any drivers or software. It just kind of immediately works. I was surprised at how quickly and easily I was able to adapt to a new technology. And I think it's a lot akin to going from a mouse to a trackball. On the last episode of Tech Check, I reviewed Azul's Link Air Mouse Control. Now, the WOLFEE also has Air Mouse functionability. If you click the trigger three times, it switches over to that mode. But that was still a work in progress. It didn't really work very well. But in its native state, where you use just the trackpad itself, I found that was really responsive. It has 1200 DPI of touch sensor resolution. The dexterity and the flexibility of the control is there, but since you're so used to this movement and not this movement, it takes a little bit getting used to. I think my favorite feature of WOLFEE, though, was not its trackpad, which allows for clicks and taps, or its right click button on the side, but the main primary trigger, which works as the left click. But it also works as a scroll wheel just by swiping your fingers up and down. When I demoed WOLFEE, I also had a chance to sit down with its founder and designer, Yimbo Lee, and it's obvious the passion he has for his product. He wants to fill a niche and a void in this computer interface technology space that hasn't yet been tapped by a device quite like this. Certain aspects of it have been handled before in other, better devices, but none of them all in one small, lightweight, really seamlessly designed device. During the 3-hour product demo with Yinbo, the number one thing he stressed to me was comfort computing. The idea that WOLFEE is designed for that lean back experience where you can just easily manipulate your Android, tablet, computer, laptop, or whatever with one hand without overthinking. And I think generally WOLFEE succeeds, with the exception of the overthinking part. Because there's only three buttons, you need to do a lot of different combinations to get all of the different results, which can be kind of tricky, especially if you don't memorize the manual first. That being said though, I think once you do get over that steep learning curve, the WOLFEE is the kind of thing that could fly through a lot of operations much quicker and much more comfortably than a traditional remote or air mouse. Perhaps the largest hidden benefit of WOLFEE is its ability to alleviate back, neck, and wrist pain, which was actually Yinbo's motivation to create the product in the first place. Now, while I haven't personally suffered any health issues from a lifetime of computing, the risks of poor posture and uncomfortable tech have affected plenty of people, and WOLFEE's ergonomic handheld design all but eliminates traditional stress points. So whether you want to pair your Galaxy S8 to your nearby smart TV and control it using a remote control, or if you just want a more comfortable Netflix experience on your computer monitor, I think WOLFEE fits a niche very well. But now for my final thoughts on WOLFEE in four key categories. Usability. Have to give it a yellow light because even though it's a prototype, there were a few too many things that didn't quite work as well as they should. I think it's going to get there eventually, but in its product state now, it's not quite a green light. As for features, I think the ability to scroll with a trigger, tap or touch on the main trackpad, have all those different functionalities just with three buttons is really impressive, so I'll give WOLFEE a green light in this category. As for comfort, I don't think I've held a remote that is more comfortable and easier to handle and use in one hand. But if you're part of the 10% of the population that's left-handed, unfortunately you're out of luck. At least for the time being, as a left-handed version could be in the works if there's a demand for it. And finally, value. I can't really give WOLFEE a score in this category because it isn't released yet and doesn't have an MSRP, but expect this to go for anything north of $100, as it is a more premium product. Now personally, I think that's a bit too expensive, but if you suffer from any of the aforementioned health issues, it could be worth picking up. out. Well, there you have it. Those are my thoughts on the WOLFEE human computer interfacing device. I think if you're a power user and you want another piece of technology in your bedroom or office or living room, I think the WOLFEE could fit that void really well. But wait and see what comes out next year, because the product that I reviewed might be totally different than the one that gets sold on Amazon. For more information about WOLFEE Technologies, check out their website in the description below. If you'd like to watch more episodes of Tech Check, please click the links on screen now or subscribe by clicking the Jogwheel icon and see all new uploads when they're released. Once again, my name is Jonathan Paula. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.